Another weekly gain for Philippine shares as cooler inflation print in the U.S. renews rate cut hopes by America's Central Bank. Michelle Ong reports.
Asian stocks traded mixed on Friday amid a volatile yen. On the plus side, fresh signs of cooling inflation in the U.S. spurred bets the Federal Reserve could start cutting rates as soon as September. Chinese stocks trading in Hong Kong enjoying their best day in 3 weeks, lifted by expectations of more policy support from the upcoming third plenum on the mainland. Global stocks now set for their sixth weekly advance, the longest stretch since March. Here at home, Philippine shares continue to climb, closing at 66.48, with the PSE index notching its third weekly gain.
Market sentiment is quite becoming hopeful, but still, they don't let their guards down. So we could expect some pessimism, some bears around the corner to take some profit, of course. But I think not as bad as heavy selling as we used to see for the previous months.
In corporate stories, SPNEC, which is building what's touted to be the world's largest solar farm in Nueva Ecija, seeing a changing of the guard from Manny to Manny. Tycoon Manny Pangilinan handing over the reins to former Aboitiz Power executive Emmanuel Manny Rubio, who was also just recently hired to lead Meralco Power Gen, which is a majority stake in SPNEC. Pangilinan will stay on as chairman of the board. SPNEC also says it is formally assigning its rights, title, and interest in the Terra Solar project, touted to be the world's largest solar farm, to Terra Solar Philippines, where it is infusing 1.05 billion pesos to support its application for an increase in authorized capital stock, allowing the entry of new partners. Pangilinan had earlier said they're negotiating with prospective foreign partners to take up a 40% stake and help finance the 200 billion peso project. Andratan's property company, Megaworld, increasing its authorized capital stock from 40.2 billion pesos to 45.7 billion to support growth and future business expansions. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.